family, friends. Flipping his guitar off. Terrible thing all day. How's it week so it's been made late? Welcome to Liverpool. If you're from a foreign country, whatever, if you're local, welcome. I was playing in the pool, in the pond, over the pool, and three pounds and a week, it was my plan. With a pocket full of tin, I was very soon taken in by a girl by the name of Maggie Mac. Maggie, 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 they have taken her away. She'll never walk down my street anymore. And by the church of God, we found her.
Thank you.
this is naughty. And how kind of you to lend me your dress, John. That's fantastic. And of course, we also have a TTS bass. So we found this young man wandering around in the back of the stage. I'm not sure I want to be have them behind me, to be honest with you.
Well, don't ask me out of the way.
Give us an easy flat mod. That's flat enough for me, right?
Can you have a bit more reverb on this mic, please?
Right, okay, this song came out originally in 1954, and it came out on a single in November 55. Without this song, the rock and roll scene in Britain maybe wouldn't even have happened, because everybody learned how to play guitars. And when rock and roll came along, the same three chords worked for rock and roll. So here we go, this is Rock Out of the Line. Sorry, I've got to get used to this.
A lot longer strap.
A long strap.
This is used at the time by my love, okay?
Well, this is the story all about the Rock Island Line. I'm having trouble with your bras, but do you understand? That Rock Island Line runs down to New Orleans. Just outside of New Orleans line, there's a big toll gate. And all the trains that go through that toll gate, they've got to pay the man some money. And you've got certain things on board, you don't have to pay man nothing. Just now there's a train going through. He yells down the man in the toll gate, says, they got cows, they got sheep, they got horses, they got hogs. Got old livestock, got old livestock. The man says, okay, well, you get on through. You don't have to pay me nothing. Let the train go through. And he gets up a little bit of steam, a little bit of speed. And he yells back down the line, the man says, bad fool for you, bad fool for you. They got big iron, big iron. Let me tell you where we're going, Lord. Down on Rock Island Line, she's a mighty road. Rock Island Line, road's a ride, yeah. Rock Island Line, she's a mighty road. It won't be right, the other one, how you might think they can't stay at the Rock Island Line. Make it right, make it wrong. I know you're listening when I'm gone. Down on Rock Island Line.
Thank you.
Dibble. Over the pond in America, something was happening at the same time, virtually at the same time, a skiffle was taking place in England. Look at my notes here. A guy called Elvis Presley. Any Elvis fans here? Yeah! In Memphis, and he went. Sam Phillips had opened this studio in Memphis. And Elvis, a year before that, in 1953, had made a record for his mum. I think it was, what was it? Happiness, yeah. But 1954, a year had elapsed, and Sam got in touch with Elvis to come in the studio and play some tracks. So Elvis was fooling around and doing some slow stuff with Bill Black and Scotty Moore. And Elvis was fooling around, and suddenly he came up with this song called That's Alright Mama. And Phillips said, wow, this is great. We must get this guy back again. Now, at the same time, there was a guy called Howie Phillips, was a DJ at the local Memphis studio. And he heard the record. He said, wow, this is great. He couldn't play this 14 times at one particular evening. And that's how That's All Right Mama became a hit in the States. And that's how Elvis's career took off. So there's three Phillipses. There's one in England and two in America. Jimmy Phillips, Percy Phillips in England, and the other guy, obviously, there. Howie, yeah. Okay, now, we're going to do That's All Right Mama. Okay, wait, let's play that, sorry.
I print these things in 24-point type, right? So they can be read. They can be read from the other side of the.
Yeah. I need another pair of glasses here.
Which we're going to do in a moment or two. Now in 1995,
This was sold at Sotheby's auction for £79,000 a tape. Mind you, they threw in the recorder as well, so that helped. And this was the, at the time, the most expensive recording in the world. And some of us guys were on it. Len, Colin, me, Pete Shotton, Eric Griffiths, and of course John. And we wrote to EMI, Len and I, separately, saying, can't you pull John's voice off, clean it up, and we'll do the backing for you? But it never happened. We have tried a few times since, and Beatles fans keep saying to us, what's going to happen to this tape? So I said, well, I think they'll wait until we all die, and they won't have to pay us any royalties on it. But we'll see what happens. Anyway, putting on style. This is Skiffle again, guys. We tell her every time she drops a thimble, she has to kiss the drummer. At the rehearsal this afternoon, he was plastered with lipstick. She's used super glue now, so.
No, he manages to escape.
Sweet 16 goes to church just to see the boy. Laughs and screams and kills.
Now be not